Joining us now here in Los Angeles, Miko Brando, who is with us almost every night after this untimely passing, longtime Michael Jackson friend attending the funeral, and Dave, yes, that's his name, Dave. He was David Rothenberg. He was set on fire in 1983, suffered, as you can see, terrible scars. Michael Jackson befriended him and paid for a lot of his surgeries. Dave is also attending the burial. Why Dave?
Well, to liberate myself from the confines of my father's criminality.
He caused the fire?
Yeah. He is a criminal, and he caused all this. To free myself of his name and his legacy, I decided to become my own person through changing my name.
We'll find out how Michael helped you, but Miko, is that a typical story of Michael helping people like this?
Absolutely. When he would hear about stories of people in need or needed help, and when we watched the news together, he'd reach out to them, send them a basket, send them a note, get well, or whatever the incident would be, and he'd always reach out to people and help people. Even driving around town, he'd stop and help people.
How'd he find out about you, Dave?
He heard about me, and he had contacted me and wanted to meet me.
How old were you at the time?
I was about 7 years old at the time.
And were you in the hospital?
I was not in the hospital at the time. I was in interim, back and forth from surgery.
And what did he do for you?
Well, basically, he befriended me. He took me into his life, which is very rare for Michael to do. But he opened up his arms to me and accepted me as a very good friend of his. And throughout the years, he never let me go.
I believe that's the hearse carrying the body into Forest Lawn. He will be interred. It looks like a beautiful place to have for him, Miko.
It's very nice. It's a very nice compound.
Yeah, we're going to be showing you a close-up of that. That is Forest Lawn. Were you surprised, Dave, to hear from him when you were seven?
Oh, it's a very interesting story, Larry. It was kind of the visit to his Encino house was very impromptu, and it was kept a secret by my mother. And I had always been kind of a admirer of his, not a fan per se, but I always loved his music. And my mother surprised me one day and brought me up to Neverland. And I entered an arcade, and there were all these Paul McCartney records all over this, The Girl Is Mine, and, you know, this and that. And I remember sitting down, and at the time, my favorite video game was Pole Position. And I was playing Pole Position, and I felt a little tap on my shoulder, and I turned around, and there was Michael.
And
you know what, Larry? What? At that moment, we embraced, and that embrace never ended throughout our whole entire friendship.
Dave, what don't we know about him we should know?
Well, I believe what people fail to realize is that Michael was a human being. Throughout the years, I think he was kind of stigmatized by the media. And I believe that wasn't really helpful to him or to anybody around him. I believe that Michael was a great person. He has never hurt a soul. And I am happy to have been his friend for all these years and been a dedicated friend.
Miko, how do you explain what Michael did for Dave?
That's just the kind of human being he was. He's very loving, caring. He loved Dave from the day he met him. They became friends. Michael helped him through the years, and that's the kind of person Michael was. I mean, he loved a lot of people. He'll be missed and loved by a lot of people.
Did he pay for a lot of your medicals?
Actually, he did not pay for my medical. My mother had great insurance at the time.
So Michael, what did he do?
Michael offered a lot of emotional support for me. He was there for me whenever I needed to talk to him. He opened up Neverland to me as a means to get away. He He was almost like a father that I never had.
Huh. Well said.